No small town gathering generates a sense of excitement and a sense of community like a dance. The call and response, the excitement, the gossip, the chatter, the expectation, and the release, and the music. After this, there will be a short intermission. Please enjoy an invitation to the dance.
Thank you. Great Plains have been described as everything from a Garden of Eden to hell with the fires burned out. That's Teddy Roosevelt.
One thing is for sure, to appreciate the Great Plains, we have to slow down and develop a sense for the subtle, for the strange. That's the world's largest ball of twine. You can't even enjoy for that? Come on. And for the unexpected, that was in some farmer's backyard in Nebraska. Early Spanish explorers compared the Great Plains to the open sea, referring to the emptiness of the endless waves and swells. Native Americans managed to sail this ocean of grass for centuries, finding harmony with its wildlife, its extremes, its weather, and its wonders. Now we have farmed, grazed, and irrigated almost every corner of the grasslands in North America, but still can find beauty in these open spaces, occasionally even reverence. Perception that becomes more poignant because of the nostalgic nature and the isolated surroundings of these sounds. A distant train whistle, children playing in the field. A crop duster buzzing like a tiny insect in the distance. A church bell. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Distance is deceptive on the Great Plains. Just as sound travels differently, so does the eye roam in extended scope to where land meets sky. Roads, fences, and poles sometimes themselves define the contour and the character of the land they inhabit. Much as a woman's dress outlines her own feminine topography. The artifacts and the implements of the prairie seem to complement the space they occupy, with their barbs and coils, rust and cracks, and all of their wonderfully peculiar geometry. The northern plains are speckled with small towns fading quietly into the prairie gumbo. Many that were founded in high hopes, but only conceived to sustain the railroad line. Naive Europeans and eager Easterners came by the trainload to a bizarre landscape that bore no resemblance to the paradise depicted in the railroad-sponsored brochures. Scorching summers, droughts, bitter cold, blizzards, tornadoes, wildfires, locusts, lack of timber, and ceaseless winds with their whirlwind. For those who are lucky to be enough on the highway, the new highway that came through at least gave us some hope. But for most, their dreams were lost in the blowing topsoil, their plans like their homes, having collapsed under the weight of the elements. When dancing with Mother Nature, we sometimes forget she always leads. She hears no plea, feels no remorse, and follows the script other than the poetry of decay. Thank you. you very much. I want to thank everybody with Ragtime and Randall, especially Don Brady, and thank Charlotte for helping the church. She's back there. She can't hear me. And thank all of you for coming. Thanks Brian Keenan and Ron Bison and everybody who played. I will be finishing off with a piece I wrote called Panoramic, accompanied by some video that took me a year to shoot, including one that almost killed me on a windmill. Hanging on with one hand and shooting with the other, and then, of course, the wind changed directions almost, knocked me right off. But this is my love letter to the Great Plains. I hope you've enjoyed it. This is Panoramic. Thank you very much.